and he had problems with Raft, Mortis, and James Vandenberg. Who was the man to come to his aid? Well, of course, it was the Cat, the former NFL player, the former college football star, the former world karate champion, Ernest Miller, had been there for Glacier almost at every turn. But when it push came to shove, it was Glacier turning his back on the Cat.
Like a lot of people in WCW, Glacier, the big change of attitude. Speaking of that, we'll see one of the changed men, Eddie Guerrero, later on Saturday night. He's going to square off against Silver King and a couple of main eventers coming up in the main event. We saw it go down last Thursday on Thunder. They are here tonight to settle it once and for all. Raven and Chris Benoit still to come.
Well, that is going to be a rematch from the recent sold-out pay-per-view. I thought, and Chris Benoit as well, as he told me on a recent edition of Thunder, that he had closed the book on his rivalry, on his feud with the Flock. But that obviously wasn't the intention of Raven and his group, because at the end of the Diamond Dallas Page U.S. title defense against Benoit this past Thursday on Thunder, it was an all-out attack by Raven and his Flock on Benoit, and even Raven DDT Benoit after warning him to beware the DDT.
Chris Benoit will get his shot at revenge later on Saturday night, but making his way to the ring, a very intense man, the Cat, and in his crosshairs, Glacier.
Well, what a well-rounded athlete with a great background the Cat is. Glacier, on the other hand, you mentioned that new style, that new attitude that he's brought to the ring. I think he's changed his actual wrestling style as well as his attitude, relying less on his martial arts background and more on his professional wrestling skills. And I think in the situation of the Cat, once he becomes more rounded and relies less on his martial arts and karate background, we're also going to see him improve quite rapidly.
Oh, take a look at this. No martial arts involved there. That's just an old slobber knocker, as they say. There goes the Cat with a backdrop on Glacier.
Talk about a total change in attitude. Remember, ooh, when Glacier first arrived, he refused to use a closed fist. Obviously, he's had a change of heart. What a kick by the Cat.
Knocked Glacier, who is no small man, not a luchador, as it were, knocked him for a loop all the way to the floor, all the way to the rail.
Scott, everyone in World Championship Wrestling and the NWO, for that matter, is talking about Super Brawl and the upcoming return bout, the biggest rematch in wrestling history, with Hollywood Hogan to face Sting, winner to gain the world's heavyweight title, as Glacier goes on his bicycle. Look at him backtrack.
The Cat waits on him at Glacier. Went into the gut and across the top rope. And the Cat is where Glacier was, and Glacier is alone in the ring. But wait a second. The Cat making his way back up to the ring apron, but Glacier's got him out of the corner of his eye.
Well, maybe just a momentary stoppage there, but he sure stopped the momentum of the Cat. Now brings him back into the ring with a vertical suplex.
Nicely executed by Glacier. I thought he was going for the cover. That's a blatant choke right in the center of the ring. Referee Scott Dickinson stepping in, thank goodness.
Just throttling him in the middle of the ring with that chokehold, and now sends him to the corner face first.
Right into the turnbuckle, face first for the Cat and Glacier. Oh, listen at those punches connect on the head of the Cat.
Again, we have to point out the closed fist from Glacier. In the past, he's talked about how effective those open hand palm thrusts can be, and that he actually preferred them over the fist. Ooh. There's one of the open hands right there.
And take a look at the damage it did on the Cat and Glacier. To the second rope in the corner, taking way too much time, letting the Cat come back, and he got the foot right in the face.
Well,
oh, boy.
The Cat was ready for him that time, and look how quickly the Cat goes to the top.
But Glacier meets him. Back first in the center of the ring. Glacier still staggered, but not out.
The Cat has been so impressive.
Watch it.
But Glacier sets for the cryonic kick.
He missed it.
Great counter by the Cat. Talk about
sweep.
Having your opponent well scouted. These two know each other so well.
The Cat with the leg sweep. Off the top. Spinning sidekick cover. Hooks the leg. He's got him, Mike. Yeah. Yeah. The Cat avenges it all. 1, 2, 3 on Glacier.
Impressive way to start out Saturday night. What a way to kick off the show. The Cat gets the win over his former tag team partner, Glacier, going to the top rope with that spinning roundhouse style kick. What a way to kick off Saturday night.
After everything that's gone down between Glacier and the Cat, what poetic justice that it was the spinning kick from the top for the Cat. Let's take a look at it again, Mike.
There we see early on in the match the front kick that stunned Glacier and gave the Cat the momentum at that point. This is what he calls the feliner, the finishing move. And we see it from another angle, that spinning roundhouse kick to the head.
Benoit and Raven still to come, but up next, it's the Public Enemy. They're on Saturday night.